Well, that's true, Jen. The prosecutor says when police tested Brett Davis's blood alcohol level, it was 0.13, above the legal limit. And police say under the influence, Davis made some very bad decisions.
Through a video monitor, 39-year-old Brett Davis listened to a judge read a long list of charges he's facing.
All of these complaints alleged conduct on the 20th day of November 2010.
Police say Davis's wild night started Saturday at the Holman Street home in Laconia he shares with his girlfriend. He's accused of ramming his pickup truck into the girlfriend's car and was gone when police arrived. But as an officer talked to Davis's girlfriend inside,
he sees the lights on his cruiser backing up, and then he came over the radio and said someone was taking his cruiser.
Police immediately began searching for the cruiser, which had a rifle in it. 25 minutes later, it turned up here on O'Shea Lane, no more than 600 yards from where it was taken from. The rifle was still inside. Police say Davis was on the run in his own truck in other towns.
The fact of the matter is this defendant was operating his vehicle in a manner that put the lives and safety of the public at risk. He was involved in this high-speed chase. He was failing to pull over.
And the prosecutor in court said Davis collided with a Gilmanton officer who chased him into Pittsfield. Davis was charged with reckless conduct for that. Police say he also admitted to taking the Laconia cruiser.
After interviewing him, he said he was trying to distract us so he could get away because he had been drinking that evening.
While he's not charged with taking the cruiser, police say other charges will be coming.
So this isn't going away for him anytime soon?
No, I don't think so. No.
Bad decisions made that night.
Oh, bad decisions, bad judgment.
Now, right now, Davis is being held on $15,000 cash-only bail. He will be back in court next month. Reporting live in the newsroom, Heather Hamill, WMUR News 9.